Speaker returned to fanfare and ceremony. He was welcomed by his deputy, Right Honorable Anita Among, the Leader of Opposition, Matthias Mpuuga, as well as a host of other officials from Parliament's administration. The Speaker wasted no time in slamming his critics for spreading, as he put it, rumors about his whereabouts. He said that he has a strong team in place that can steer business in Parliament during his absence, and that he did not understand why they were being, as he put it, so dramatic about it.
1.5 years, I never chaired Parliament. I never appeared in Parliament. You never raised the question. Now I'm away for a week, 2 weeks and a half. Actually, I'm going to demonstrate.
Speaker Jacob Olanya's absence from the public raised speculation, with some media houses reporting that he had tested positive for COVID-19 and had been flown out of the country for treatment.
When you take this,
let's go.
Today at 10 a.m., he made his grand return to Parliament, where he was welcomed by Deputy Speaker Anita Among, the Leader of Opposition Matthias Mpuuga, Commissioners of Parliament, and other legislators. He even held a high-level meeting with Prime Minister Robin Anabanja.
We expect him to start from where his deputy has ended, and of course carry on forward the Parliament of Uganda. You know, this Parliament is full of new members who need the guidance, and I believe he has the capacity to do that.
Afterwards, Olanya graced the orientation workshop of opposition members of Parliament, where he spoke out on his absence, saying his leadership in Parliament will be run as a team.
There's a word we want to remove from Parliament and replace with another. We want to replace remove the word I, and replace it with we. I has not taken us anywhere, will never take us anywhere. We together will achieve a lot.
We have agreed that the House will always start at 2. And we have also agreed that once the House is sitting, there will be no side business within the building. So thank you so much, Leader of Opposition. We expect you and your troops in the House.
Olanya slammed members of Parliament like Gilbert Olanya of Kilak South and Joseph Sewungu of Kalungu, who he accused of fueling anxiety and hullabaloo over his absence. He asked them why they kept silent when he was denied a chance to chair Parliament for a full year in the previous term.
Because they have made it a mission to demand for my presence. And yet last year, for a whole 1 year, when I was not in Parliament, they never uttered a word. So I just wanted to come and find out. For 1.5 years, I never chaired Parliament. I never appeared in Parliament. You never raised the question. Now I'm away for a week, 2 weeks and a half. Actually, I'm going to demonstrate. Let's stick to standards and principles.
Olanya also took a swipe at people who he says were spreading speculations that he had died.
What we are losing in this country is something called humanity. And we should take it seriously. If somebody is sick, why declare that person dead? Why declare that person dead? Why? I thought the usual thing would be to pray for that person to recover. What is happening to our country? If it is true indeed somebody is ill, like we know so many who are ill, why should we be painting and vanishing coffins for them? Why?
He urged MPs to uphold the decorum of Parliament live to show purpose to the public and pledged to send some opposition members of Parliament to the UK to learn modern multi-party politics of building consensus in Parliament for a common cause.
Positioning for coming to Parliament is an electoral process. It's a competitive process. People vie from different positions. Colour is for elections. Once that is done, you're a national parliament, like the deputy speaker said. We push away the colors. There's something I want you as the opposition and the government chief whip and other people to go and study from other parliament. We're going to constitute a team to go and study how this works. It is not a Uganda, it's not only the parliament of Uganda that has opposition. All parliaments have opposition, but how do they work? How do they work so neatly that you think there is no opposition? And there is such strong opposition which is taking government next year.
The speaker expressed concern over the poor quality of debate in Parliament and tipped MPs to work on sharpening their arguments rather than sharpening their voices.
The usual channels are not written in any books. They are not written in any statutes or regulations. It's just a way that the government and the opposition work behind the scenes and deliver as if there was no opposition. They go, sit behind the scenes, they negotiate everything. Say, this one, we don't agree. This one, make these changes. This one's.
The Speaker's office, which was previously occupied by former Speaker Rebecca Kadaga, has been completely refurbished. Ulanya is expected to start chairing sittings next week. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.